In my last video, I have explained about Weil-Lambert's law and its derivation. Now, I am going to explain about deviations from Weil-Lambert's law or deviations of Weil-Lambert's law. Okay, let's see. This topic is also important for GPA point of view. Okay, let's see. A system is said to be obey Weil-Lambert's law a straight line when a straight line is obtained from a origin. Okay, when a straight line is obtained from a origin, if we plot a graph between concentration versus absorbance, okay, what system is said to be obey Weil-Lambert's law? When if straight line should be obtained like this, if straight line should be obtained like this, whenever we plot a graph between concentration versus absorbance. Okay, the meaning of this is as the concentration increases, absorbance also gradually increases. Okay, here by using of absorbance values of various concentration, okay, you will get straight line from the origin. Okay, then if straight line is not obtained, that indicates deviations from linear relationship between concentration versus absorbance. Okay, if straight line is not obtained, what that indicates? There is a deviation between, there is no linear relationship between concentration and absorbance. That indicates, okay, there is no linear relationship between concentration versus absorbance. That is the point. Okay, here deviation from Weil-Lambert's are reported as positive deviation and negative deviation. Positive and negative deviation, then concave upwards and downwards respectively. Okay, here positive from the graph we can conclude that positive deviation can be considered as a, if it is obtained concave upwards like this, if the graph obtained like this, okay, concave upwards, that is positive deviation. If graph obtained by concave downwards, that is known as negative deviation from the graph. Okay, here what happens if positive deviation will occur or negative deviation will occur? Okay, positive deviation results small change in concentration produces greater changes in the absorbance. If positive deviation occurring means what will happen? Small change in concentration will also produce greater changes in the absorbance. That is the result of positive deviation. If negative deviation occurs, that results greater change in the concentration produce small changes in the absorbance. That is negative. In the positive, small change in concentration gives rise to greater change in absorbance. It is quite opposite to the negative. Greater change in concentration produce small change in the absorbance. That is negative deviation. Here we have found deviations are mainly two types. Okay, one is physico-chemical deviation and second one is instrumental deviation. Okay, let's see first physico-chemical deviation. Okay, as the name suggests, a deviation occurs due to physical properties or chemical, physical and chemical properties of the compound or solution, sample solution. Let's see. Okay, if the concentration of the solution is more than 10⁻²⁰ molar, the linear relationship between concentration and absorbance is not obtained. Okay, if we are going to analyze the solution, if it is having more than 10⁻²⁰ molar concentration, if the sample solution concentration is more than 10⁻²⁰ molar, what will happen? Here it may be possible there is no linear relationship existing between concentration and absorbance. If there is no linear relationship, means deviation will be occur. This deviation will come under chemical or physico-chemical deviation, first one. Okay, and second one, deviation may occur if the solution species, sample solution species, undergoes polymerization. Okay, here second example is if the sample solution undergoes polymerization, that may also cause deviation. Let's see example. Benzyl alcohol in chloroform exists polymerization. Here you take benzyl alcohol. Okay, here it undergoes polymerization. Here this is the C6H5CS2OH. This is the benzyl alcohol. Okay, it can also be converted in polymeric form. C6H5CS2OH taken as 4. So this here this is having different result, and this polymeric form of benzyl alcohol having different results. So this may also cause polymerization, may also cause deviation. Okay, deviation. Then deviation due to change of color. Okay, that example is deviation is due to change of color. For example, changing of color of dichromate ion on dilution with water. Here, whenever dichromate ion diluting with water, the color may be changed. Okay, if the color changes, means here deviation may also be occur. Okay, let's see dichromate ion. HCl to OCl2 minus, that is dichromate ion. It is having orange color. When it is dilute with water, it can produce chromate ion. CrO4 minus chromate ion. It is having yellow color. Here through the intermediate product. Okay, 2HCrO4 minus. So this color change, orange to yellow. Here this color, due to change of color also, deviation may be occur. Okay, and next one, deviation occur if color solute ionizes, dissociate, association in solution. Even if a solution, if solute undergoes ionization with other molecules, solute undergoes ionization or dissociation or association with other molecule, that may also leads deviation. And next one, deviation occur due to refractive index of the sample. Here sometimes refractive index of the sample may also cause the deviation. Next, Bayes' law cannot apply to the suspension. You have to remember this. Suspensions cannot be applied to the Bayes-Lambert's law. Okay? Here, Bayes' law cannot apply to the if fluorescent compounds present. If any material consists of fluorescent material, that can also be not applicable to the Bayes-Lambert's law. That you have to remember. Then Bayes' law, it can also not applicable if absorbent material is coagulated. Okay, coagulated materials also not applicable to the Bayes-Lambert's law. What are the three? First, it is not applicable to suspensions and as well as fluorescence compounds and as well as if it is coagulated. These three type of compounds cannot be applicable to the Bayes-Lambert's law. Then, deviation may also occur due to presence of impurities. Impurities also having absorbance at particular level. It leads to deviation. Then, environmental factors such as temperature, pressure may also cause us deviation. These are the physicochemical deviation. First one, I underline the main word. Here, concentration having 10 power minus 2 molar. Then, deviation will occur. Then, anaerobic polymerization. Then, color of this dichromate ion, color of dichromate ion and dilution with water. Then, if solute undergoes ionization, dissociation or association. Then refractive index of the sample may also cause deviation. Suspensions, fluorescence compounds and coagulant materials may not be applicable to the Bayes-Lambert's law. And impurities may cause deviation. And temperature and pressure may also cause the deviation. These are physicochemical deviation. Here from which we can ask, we can expect the question from GPAC also. If the following compounds which is not applicable to Bayes-Lambert's law. Here's answers are options are suspensions, fluorescence compounds, coagulant material, and fourth option is all the above. Then we have to choose for option 4, all the above. Okay. Then second deviation is instrumental deviation. Okay, second type of deviation, instrumental deviation. Their name itself suggests the deviation occurring due to the instrument. Okay, let's see what are the types. Deviation may occur if monochromator light is not used. If we are not using monochromator, okay, if we are not using monochromatic light, so deviation may occur. Okay, deviation may occur if width of slit is not proper. If width of slit is not proper, we have entrance slit and exit slit in the instrumentation. If the width of slit is not proper, what will happen? It allows undesirable relation to fall on the sample solution. Unwanted relation will fall on the sample solution through passing through slit. So it will also cause deviation. So that is instrumental deviation. And last one, deviation may also occur when filters are using instead of monochromators. Okay, here mainly monochromators we are using for conversion of polychromatic light to monochromator. Okay, in the presence of gates are there. Whenever you are using monochromator, less deviation will occur. Deviation will not be occur. If you use instead of monochromator, if you use filters, mean it is very possible to occur of deviation. Filters generally useful for absorption of unwanted radiation. Okay, purpose. In this kind, deviation will occur. So, instrumental deviation mainly, if you not use monochromatic light, if the width of slit is not proper, and filters, whenever we are using filters, these are the instrumental deviation. So, this is the body of deviations of Bayes-Lambert's law. Okay, if you have any doubt regarding this topic, please comment in the comment box. And if you like this video, please subscribe and you can share to your friends. Thank you very much.